So how can we serve together this year? Serving is one of those things when we look at, it's really thinking outside of ourselves and looking at other people. How can we serve other people besides just focusing on ourselves? And you guys are doing that as cell group leaders. You're serving other people. You've got a group of people that you're serving, and that in itself is a huge task, which is very, very important, which Jason has stressed already. And we can't thank you guys enough for serving this body of believers that God has, sovereignly placed in front of you. So as we serve, how do we do that as a group of people? I don't know how many times I've seen in my own life and in other people's lives the idea of what serving does to bring people together. Serving one another, serving outside of your group, serving in the church. There's just something about that that really gives enthusiasm. There's great joy in that. The more you look inward at yourself, the more like you're just frustrated and discouraged because it's like, oh, it's just all about me. It's all about me. But when we turn ourselves out and we start serving others, there's great joy in that. And really to have that mentality within your group, you guys lead that as cell group leaders. You're leading the example of saying, hey, let's go serve this. So the fact that you're serving, the fact that you're involved, the fact that you're pushing things that we as a church are pushing, that's a huge, huge thing. I mean, that's even like the men's retreat coming up. Like, hey, everybody should go to men's retreat. I mean, I'm not going to go, but everybody else should go. I mean, that doesn't make a lot of sense, right? I mean, so, hey, I'm serving you, I'm serving in the church, therefore, hopefully you will serve. So just a couple of things. As far as serving within the church, if you can just encourage people in your group, if they're members, they should be serving. I mean, that is part of being a member at Saylorville, is you're serving in some aspect, in some way. So if you can stress that, that's a huge thing. That's just going to give buy-in for your people within your group. So if you can serve there. And then in the community, within your neighborhoods, within your neighbors, even talking about wearing the Saylorville shirts. I mean, I see people wear those shirts and I'm like, oh Lord, I hope they're a good testimony. I hope they're not acting like idiots, because you're representing this church, but you're also, you're representing Christ, most importantly, So, but as you're in your neighborhoods, as you're in your communities, as you're in your workplace, on teams, you're out there just in the community representing your group and then this church and Christ as a whole thing. But, as you talk about the community, just how can your group minister to the community? Whether that's in your neighborhood, helping out your neighbors and getting your group together to come and help, or at your school, maybe your group gets together to help out at school. There's a school thing that needs to be done. Obviously there's a lot of us that have kids in schools, and that's a great ministry to get involved in your school. But maybe your cell group can help with that. A couple of other ministries. We actually have two people in here. Jeannie Thomas with Alpha Women's Center. That's a great ministry to get involved. Can you use help, Jeannie?
Of course.
So that's dealing with pregnancies and abortion and clothing and all sorts of stuff like that. So if you want to help out with that, that'd be a great opportunity to help as a cell group. And then Preston is over here with Freedom for Youth. They just opened a brand new coffee shop. You should go check it out. It's beautiful. Very nice. But that's another thing to help out with at-risk teens down, what's the street you guys are on?
MLK and
Hickman. MLK and Hickman downtown. So that's another opportunity to get involved in the community. And then just as cell groups as a whole, you guys, we talked about Coffee Cove. That is a big, big deal. There's a ton of people that come in every week to Coffee Cove. There's lots of relationships going on. So the fact that you can do that to the best of your ability, and put out a good spread with the fruit and all the food and stuff, that's a big deal. It's a testimony to visitors. They go back there, they get free coffee and free treats, and it's a big deal. And you guys are doing a great job. I mean, I wasn't trying to be sarcastic or anything. You really are doing a good job. So keep it up. And then senior citizens have a lot of needs. So if your group as a whole would like to get involved with that, the senior saints, they always have, like, especially now with a leaves cleanup like that. I see Randy and Pam B.U.B. back there. They would be someone to connect with and talk with. Arlen and Judy Thorson, be able to help out with those things. One of the things, you talk about the sister cell groups, babysitting for maybe your sister cell group. If you're an older group that, your kids are all gone, if you can help out with a younger group, all you younger groups are saying like, amen, like that would be awesome. The babysitting thing, that's a big deal. If you can help out with that and serve another group, it doesn't have to be your sister cell group, but maybe another group you can help out with and babysit and help out to just be a an encouragement to them. And then obviously, the moving, the meals for babies, hospital visits, people in the hospital. I know that we've had three of our girls have been in the hospital for extended periods of time. My wife broke her ankle at one point, and that was for me the first time I saw firsthand what that meant for the church to be the church and to be Christ to us as a family. I mean, I had people coming over and cleaning our house. We had people coming and bringing us food. We had people playing with our kids. I mean, that happened consistently over and over and over again. And it was just an awesome example of what that means. And it's one meal or whatever, but that's a big, big deal to minister to one another, people in your cell group, other cell groups. So if you can help out with that. And then just serving alongside one another. How can you serve each other and even in your own group? There's just lots of opportunities within your own group. I know our group, we've done egress windows for guys. We've done re-roofs. We've ripped apart houses. And there's something about serving together that's different than sitting in a living room. You all of a sudden are like, I had no idea they knew what they were talking about. And they know how to do that. And that person oh my goodness, that's awesome. And you've got all these connections and you're talking together. So the more you can look for opportunities to serve with each other and for one another, I think it just brings a whole nother dimension. It's like you've got dimension one, and then here's another dimension that will just add depth to your cell group and your ministry together.